Hello everybody, my name is Miguel and today I'm going to be showing you how to create a plan and have Magento 2 auto-install. First of all, you got to log in into my.nexcess.net and under the Plans tab, you got to see a button that says Create Plan. First of all, you got to select the type of application you're going to be using. It's going to be Magento for us. The size of the server you're going to be using, which is going to be an extra small today, and then click Next. Once you click Next, you're going to be seeing your account, billing, and payment information already pre-filled, and under the plan information, you gotta select a server location, a name plan or a nickname, and click on Auto Install Magento. Keep in mind, Magento 2.4 and up requires Elasticsearch to be installed, which means we are gonna be creating an Elasticsearch container for you. Now, once you hit Purchase, you are gonna be completing your orders, and it usually takes between 2 and 8 minutes to have your server up and running. Now, when everything is done, you're going to be landing on this page where you can see the temporary domain we created for you. And on the left side, you will see a bunch of really cool features like environmental variables, including the application admin, PHP version, Redis, and IP address of the plan. Then under the performance tab, you can add your own performance monitoring new rally keys, see how much disk space you're taking, enable or disable the cloud accelerator, and even enable Varnish 2. You can see how much bandwidth you have consumed, and even see how much PHP FVM workers you are consuming at the moment. There's also the cloud auto-scaling toggle, which enables or disables the automatic auto-scale we built into the platform. And then under your access tab, you can edit your SSH SFTP keys. So in here you can create new passwords or add FTP users to your servers, and under settings you can see the plan location, if cloud auto-scaling is enabled or disabled, and how much of your servers you are consuming. There's also the MySQL tab where you can quickly add a database and user and see the databases and users we created for your auto-install. Now, I'm going to skip email and schedule tasks, but I'm going to go right to containers where you can see the Elasticsearch containers we created for you and a bunch of other containers you can create, right? Like RabbitMQ for queues, Solr, and Varnish Cache for cache. Now, I know this is pretty straightforward, but I haven't shown you all the features, so I encourage you to try some of these. And if there's anything else you would like to see, you know where to reach me. It's either Twitter or LinkedIn. Hope you enjoy this.